Zoom backgrounds are amazing. Whether it's covering up a messy living space, blocking out your housemates,
sup dudes,
or just giving your colleagues the impression you're highly organized and professional. You can even have a little fun with it. Want to know how to create a background for yourself? Well, you've come to the right place.
Dude, I'm on a Zoom call here.
Hi there, I'm Hamish, working in the strategic integrations team here at Canva. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a range of Zoom backgrounds using Canva. We'll cover how to download ready-made templates and add them to your Zoom account, along with how to create designs from scratch. Before we get started though, hit that subscribe button to stay updated. That way you'll be notified next time we upload a video like this one. All right, want to see the easiest way to get yourself a groovy Zoom background? Let's jump into Canva and check out some templates. I'll type Zoom background in here. There are so many designs to choose from. There are funny ones like this and more serious ones for work purposes. Ones with the crown symbol are for Pro and Canva for Teams users. Anything without is free to use for everyone. I like designs like this, this, and this. But I know people in my office would much prefer something like this, or an understated design like this. No matter what you're into, you're guaranteed to find something you like given the sheer number of templates on offer. And when you do, and you're halfway to having it as your background. To download this design, I'll go to Share, then click here and download it as a PNG file. Once it's saved to my computer, I can upload it straight to Zoom, ready for my next meeting. Let me show you how. I'm already logged in, so I'll go to Preferences, then find Backgrounds and Filters. Now I'll click on this symbol to upload the image. Once it's uploaded, it should apply automatically. And there we go. It's that simple. Now let's say I want to create a background that's sure to impress the boss. I'll start with a blank page this time, then upload the company logo. Once it's loaded, I'll place it over here and resize it by dragging the corner. Next, I'll add a colored background. Instead of picking any old color, I'll select from the document color palette. This feature is handy for identifying colors that make up a logo or any other graphic for that matter. Now, I'll add some decorative elements to give the design some depth. Regardless of what you're designing, remember that while you're sitting at your computer, your body will be blocking the majority of the center third, meaning that no one will see this. To serve as a reminder, I like to add a figure like this into my design and then delete it before I download it. That way, I won't be tempted to place any text or important graphic information around that area. All right, that's looking pretty good. Let me show you how it looks as my wallpaper. If you're looking to score brownie points from the boss, surely this is the way to do it. Guaranteed to result in a 10 to 20% pay increase in the next year. Tell them Hamish authorized it. I could even share this design as a template for my colleagues to use. Imagine the boss's faces when they arrive at the meeting and we all have the same background. Let's jump back into Canva and I'll show you how to share the easiest way. First, I'll lock the elements that I don't want them to touch. I'll partially lock the name. That's a lock with a little pencil. Partial lock is perfect in this case, as I want them to put their names and pronouns in, but I don't want them to change the font or position. Then I'll head up to Share and hit Template Link. Now I can copy and paste this into an email, DM, or even the chat box during my next Zoom call. My colleagues will get their own template with all designs and locked elements preserved. All right, I've got one more business background to show you before we move on to some playful designs. This time, I'll show you how to customize a template to create some promotional content. Let's say I've been invited to speak at an online conference and I want to advertise my ebook to the audience. Instead of beginning from scratch, I'll find a template that'll help me start inspired. Ah, this could work. I'll get rid of the plant and the logo. Let me drop an iPhone frame on the page. Frames are great because you can just drop any image into them. I'll upload my book cover. Drag it onto the frame. Nice. That's sure to drum up some interest. Now, I know I said that would be the last business-related design, but I just thought of one more. A background that features a meeting agenda. For now, I'll show you some of my fave templates, but if you'd like some tips on how to design agendas from scratch, type more in the comments section and I'll try to cover it next time. This one's great for a classroom setting. I'd use something like this for a casual meeting, and a style like this for a webinar. All right, we've well and truly covered backgrounds for work, so let's move on to some more playful designs. Do you want to see my personal favorite? Ta-da! I'm an angel. Hey, I look pretty good actually. I forgot to mention, the designs don't need to be static. You can also include animated elements like these. Just make sure you download the file as a video instead. Do you want me to show you? Since I'm an angel, I actually can't really say no, can I? Maybe I'd be better suited as a devil. Hold up while I make some small changes. All right, that's more like it. I'll download this as an MP4. And I'll upload it the same as before, but select this option instead. Now I have the option of switching from devil to angel, according to my mood. How good's that? Here's another animated design that'll get people laughing. I found it by searching funny Zoom backgrounds. There are seriously stacks of good ones listed under those search terms. Like this, this, and this. So what are you waiting for? Now it's your turn to choose a template or design your own wacky Zoom background. Let me know in the comments what you plan to use it for. Will it be strictly business or something fun like online trivia? Regardless of whether you go for something fun or serious, make sure to get around to uploading it before your next meeting. Did you find this video helpful? If the answer is yes, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel before you head off. Or maybe share this video with a colleague. We release new videos weekly and I'd really hate for you to miss out. In fact, you can check out some of them now. Here are a few of my faves. I hope you enjoy them. Thanks for watching.